A log line has to be short and juicy, but give you enough that you want to hear more. You rise up in TV. You start as a staff writer, then you're a story editor, executive story editor, co-producer, producer, supervising producer, co-executive producer, executive producer. So those are all the jobs that you can have along the way. As you gain more experience. Once you're in a room, I think in the best rooms, it's very egalitarian in terms of like, the best ideas are gonna win out. I see people that, are excellent and amazing and wanna go from being a staff writer to a showrunner. And I'm always like, slow down, because I feel like the levels in between, you just gain so much experience. You also just learn different ways that people work and the range of ways that you can tell stories. You learn a lot of the shorthand, you learn a lot of the math of how you break episodes. So you're not like, what do I do here? You're like, oh, okay, I know I've got to complicate it here. And then, there's just a lot of structure that you can learn from doing it over and over and over again. When it's your turn, you pick the best practices for you and for how you think and for what room you thought was the most successful. And then you also have a wide network of people that you've worked with. Each step of the journey was important to me to prepare me for being a showrunner. That said, there's nothing that prepares you from being a showrunner. I thought it was very prepared because I'd been the number two on many shows and I was like, oh, I'm ready. I know what this is. Oh my gosh, I didn't know what any of it was. It is just a vast amount of work because you're doing three jobs. You're doing the job of the writer's room, which is what you were doing originally. Then you're overseeing production, which is really what you spend all day long sort of troubleshooting and prepping and preparing. And then you have to oversee editorial. So, on Jane, editing was at least 40 hours a week. And all day long, I was answering production and making sure that because everything bottlenecks at you. And if you don't make quick decisions, then no one else can move forward. In the beginning of the day, I always wanted to make sure that the writers, I had responded to everything that they had come up with the night before and given direction so that they could keep moving forward. And you're just kind of trying to do that with every department. You have to put together the writer's room so you have a lot of different points of view, because otherwise, you don't want to be just bouncing ideas off yourself. It depends what you need at that moment. You might need somebody that is more of a structure person. You might need somebody that's more, like big ideas and big dreams, and you want to make sure you get all the right ingredients into one group. Sometimes, somebody would say something and I'd say, no, that's not the direction I want to go. And then later that night I'd get an email saying like, I know you didn't like this, didn't want to bring it up again in the room, but here's why I think this could be interesting. And about half the times I'd be like, yeah, okay, let's talk about that tomorrow. So it's about like sort of reading the room too, so that you're not slowing down the room. But if you have something you believe in, like there's nothing I loved more as a showrunner than like somebody writing to me about an idea for the show after work, because I was like, oh, they're still thinking about it. Who doesn't love passion? And even if you don't take it, you appreciate the effort and the thought and how hard it is. I always start with like, the main character and all their inner lives and all their conflicts. And then for me, as I go, I always end up taking a pass on my pilot from every character's point of view, so that no character is just like a cog in the machine of somebody else's story. They have a point of view and they're specific. Every character's specific, and that's what I look for in the script, is just the specificity of characters, uniqueness of voice, that you can't, suddenly give this line to that person. It wouldn't work. I'm not afraid to tear things apart, and I think that that's a lot of writers starting out are nervous about going into a full rewrite. What I always say is like, just save it under a different name. You have your script. Your script is there. It exists. It's not going anywhere, but don't be afraid to like fuck up the beginning and see what happens to it, because a lot of times you're not starting it at the right place. And or you're, like the one sentence that you thought was the center of it suddenly is not holding anymore. So like, see what it would be like without that center and what would come out of it. And a lot of times I go back to what I had, but I've gotten out more information, or a lot of times I lose what I originally thought I needed to do in this pilot, because I'm just not afraid to rewrite. A real part of the process is like interrogating your script and making sure that you're not just holding on to something because you thought that that was the thing. What would happen if that thing changed? Mm-hmm. And it might be like, it doesn't work, but it might be that it unlocks a lot of other things. Communication, I think, is just the most important thing, and communication with every department level, and like understanding that every department is the most important department to them. So like the props department, you have just written a show that is all about the pregnancy test and like what it's going to look like. Is it a plus or a minus, or is it a pink or a blue? Like, that's how they're reading it, because they want their job to be, their part of the show to be excellent. So I think it's about like respecting every position, take their department seriously, because it all is what you're seeing on the screen.